Oh, yeah, you know what it is. Well Connected Wednesdays, Stop Beefing Radio, Viewyoulive.com, 103.7 The Beat. Hey, it is an honor and a pleasure to be in the presence of a real, I ain't gonna say nigga, but a real person.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? A solid brother. You know what I'm saying? Real talk. We have none other than Naptown legend.
In the building.
Nut. I ain't gonna say, look, come on,
I took the little off.
Yeah, he took the little off, you know, we ain't here, but real talk. We got Nut, you know what it is, he in the building, MGG.
MGG,
BTM, you know what it is.
Already. The empire in the building.
Come on, man.
I appreciate y'all having me, man. Number, love, and respect, you feel me?
Man, it's an honor, bro, you know what I'm saying, real talk. Like, if it was anybody ever that represented what Naptown was about in the music, if it wasn't none other, it was you. Real talk, man. You know what I'm saying? The real Nap. You hear that song? Various songs. Thumping in the club, they bang harder than the national artists.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Slapping.
That was like, I mean, that was, you know, one of the first artists, you know, like I said, when I moved here, you know, people talk about, you know what I'm saying? Nut. You know what I mean? So.
Been at the streets.
They bid,
come on, man. Hey,
I'm the past and the present. You feel me? A lot of people can't say that.
Nah, real talk, bro. Real talk.
So that's what's up, man. So you in the building tonight, man. Let's get right down to it, man. I called you. We was on the phone. You was like, look, man, I got a lot to say. You know what I'm saying? I got a whole lot to say. Got a lot of things, you know what I mean, going on as well. You know what I mean? In the background. So we're going to get right into it, man. You know, talk a little bit about, you know, the background. How did you become the Naptown legend? You know what I'm saying? Everybody knows today, man. Talk a little bit about that, man. Talk about the background.
Shit, man. It really all started from, see, this is a build up from like when I was like 10 years old and jumped off the porch when I got jumped into my neighborhood.
Yeah.
Back when you had to get jumped into 30th Street. I'm original murder one, you feel me? You know what I mean? That M1 shit is over with. It ain't like it used to be. I'm original M1. You know, we had codes. It was a certain way we moved. I'm from 30th and Sherman, 30th and Forest, man. And shout out to my whole neighborhood. Shout out to the whole neighborhood, you feel me? I love all my people. You know what I mean? And I'm the dirty old golden child. You know what I mean? Golden child of that area, you feel me? But I jumped off the porch at 10, and I got jumped into that, you know what I mean? I got jumped into 30th Street. And, we was basically kids, we ran around, we wasn't doing too much but stealing bikes and stealing out of stores and, you know, beating up little dudes for their jackets and all that, you know what I mean? We didn't get our way into, you know what I mean, all the way full-fledged into it until, you know what I mean, a couple years later. As the years progressed, we got more and more into the street. Yeah. But what I'm saying is, I'm saying that to say that I earned my stamp in a whole bunch of different ways.
Right.
You know what I mean? I've been certified before the music. So when I got out of prison in 2002, I got out of prison. You know what I mean? I had my mind made up. I used to talk to my little brother on the phone. My mama telling me he getting caught with weed and pistols and all that. And I'm telling him, man, look, fuck all that. You need to jump on some player shit. I need you to be out there when I get out there because I'm about to do this music. I'm about to cut up, you feel me?
Right.
You know what I mean? But I didn't know that it was going to happen the way that it happened. You know, rest in peace, Strike G. Shout out to my dog, Ice Mike. Them was my CEOs. But when I came home, God had already had it set out for me.
FOE.
Yeah, that's when I got signed to FOE Records. And what people really don't know, they cut me like 30 bands to sign that. So it already.
So that was a real deal. You signed the record deal.
It always been, you know, all praises due to the big dog. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It always been quality with me.
Yeah.
I ain't never have to go to the rinky dink studios in the clouds. I ain't seen none of that.
Right.
Even though I've been rapping since I was little, writing raps in elementary school, cutting up. You know what I mean?
Right.
When I got out, they basically already had a concert bringing 8-Ball and MJG here.
So say you went on tour or something.
Yeah, I went on tour with them. But I've been on Strike G since when we first moved up here from Mississippi. See, a lot of people don't know I wasn't even born here. you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I was just raised here, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? I was born in St. Louis, but I moved from there when I was only some months old. My family roots really from Mississippi, mm-hmm. you know, so my mother had me in St. Louis and moved back to Mississippi. And I was raised there till after first grade. We came up here. I've been up here. Since this is all I know. You know what I mean? This is what taught me how to live my life. Gave me my slang, my swag, my everything. You feel me? Where I went through my pain, my struggles, my knowledge. You know what I mean?
So you became a man in the Midwest.
Yeah, Indianapolis. This is where I'm from. You know what I mean? But when I got out of prison, they was having a concert with 8-Ball MJG. Shout out to my nigga Ray Real. He called himself See the Truth Man. You know what I mean? Free my nigga Jump. You know what I mean? These are the guys I started with on a serious level with the music.
They was your label mates.
Right. Like I said, rest in peace, Strike G. I love you, nigga. I still represent for you. And goddamn it, shout out to my dog Ice Mike. You know, them was my CEOs. They was young and bred it up. I was 21 years old. You know what I mean? And We went to the concert, I mean, at the concert, you know, I was just basically kicking it, you know what I mean, kicking back. Shit, they had enough money to where they rented a tour bus and went on here and went on tour with them. So I'm riding with them, rocking with them. A lot of people don't know 8-Ball and MJG, they wanted to sign me, you feel me? And me being a real nigga that I am, I kept it solid because the only reason I'm even with y'all
is because how you came to it, yeah, right.
And I know they already put a bug in my ear. We ain't did no paperwork or none of that. They already put a bug in my ear. Like, Strike, he know me from when I was in elementary school back. He already know I'm sick. And Ray Real was in prison with me. So Ray Real got out. They was already doing their thing with Ray Real. And Ray Real was like, man, I'm telling you, y'all need to fuck with Shorty. It was calling me Shorty Big Head at the time, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And you know, y'all need to fuck with Shorty. He down there cutting up. You know what I mean? I had prison on lock. I mean, dudes really paying me soups, and this is the shit God was molding me to let me know.
So it was coming with that commissary.
Nah, they come with their commissary for me to cut them songs. And they real concerts. I stand up on a picnic table, niggas that was in Westville with me, I tell you. I come from out of that weight pal, because that's all I did was lift weights. I went on no basketball court or none of that. You feel me? They was fouling too much on there anyway. But I came out there weight pal. And I had people lined up with soups, zoom zooms, and wham whams. I like dark sticks, you feel me, to put my peanut butter on there to hit that protein for my workout.
Hey, yeah, make it make sense.
I get on that table, I had my beat man, they hit that beat, and when I rock it, I had COs and everything reciting it. See, this is a lot of stuff that people don't know is that I had COs and people getting out of prison, going back to Chicago, talking about me so heavy that I got a letter from Don Juan, the pimp. He was writing me in there. He tried to sign me while I was in prison.
They heard you was so cold.
He tried to sign me from in prison.
Man, I told you, man. Your music, your lyrics, your whole everything about you, you know what I'm saying? You as an entertainer, it speaks to a certain type of people in a certain type of way. That's why fell up in the club.
Come on, man.
That's it, man. We appreciate that too, bro.
A lot of people that do it just because they got money. Or and there's so many simple rappers out now. And then when I first came out, I had the whole streets rocking with me with no Instagram, no MySpace, no. They got it good and easy now.
Hey, I always say that, man.
We got it good and easy because I'm still relevant. I'm still standing in the water with whoever. You know what I mean? They still rocking my CDs to this day. You hear people rap pack pull up at the gas station, rocking it. You feel me?
Right.
But I'm selling. I'm making money off of this music. iTunes, hand to hand. You know what I mean? I'm selling verses, 1,000 a pop, sometimes 1,500. Oh. If we cool, give me 500.
Y'all heard that right here. Hey, hold on. How many times does a person who got the streets on lock tell you that they will give you an opportunity to touch that for 500 stack? Come on, man. That's real.
Come on, man.
That's well connected, man.
Absolutely.
I really don't want to lose sight on what I was talking about because when I had came back from, 8-Ball and MJG was trying to sign me. I'm talking about we was kicking it heavy and them is my guys. I never asked them for shit. Anytime they came in the city, I had free weed for them, free liquor, and females for them.
So you gonna turn up?
Every time. I never asked them, man, put me on the song or tell somebody about me. None of that. That's what they always liked about me. When they come in the city, I meet them at their room. I got some chicks waiting on them. I got a free sack of weed for them. You know what I mean? Because I know they like to blow and they like the Indianapolis. The Indianapolis weed. See, a lot of people don't know that ain't never been outside of Indianapolis that we got a different type of swag.
Hey, man.
Even in them big cities, we be smoking better than them.
Come on.
Hey, for real. Man, seriously, though.
But I don't disrespect no other cities, though. I got love for the whole world.
Naptown always show up.
Yeah, you know what I mean? But it's, you know, a lot of cities are showing up and showing down. But what I'm saying is, I understand the difference in us, though. That's why I always try to bring that Naptown shit in my music. You know what I mean? Instead of just doing what everybody else doing, I try to give them Naptown, that Midwest shit, that line dance shit, that shit we do, shit I grew up knowing about.
Come on, man. That's
good. And when they was trying to sign me, I didn't do it. You know what I mean? And my niggas gave me a bank, they gave me a bag to sign. You feel me? Cut me up, put VVS's all on my neck. I'm riding candy. God damn it, spinning rims,
good
diamonds, eating good, dressing good, go to the
music
mall,
sounding great.
Go to the mall and god damn it, with pajamas on, leave out that motherfucker with a $1,500 outfit on. You know what I mean? But that ain't the way that I went in the joint though. I went in the joint a straight wild boy, rebel. You know what I mean? I probably kept $1,000 or something in my pocket or something like that. Kept a haircut. I was cutting my own hair. I was cutting the whole neck.
Mm-hmm.
Doing all the tattoos, all that. You know what I mean? But I kept a pistol on me. I was goddamn it, off hard drugs, and I was
all the way through. Changed the name, but you was the proverbial little nut. Yeah,
so this is what. This ain't, it ain't just me coming out hard with the music. But what made them respect the music is that all these niggas on these hoods know me from juvenile to county. You know what I mean? School.
Real street niggas.
The streets. They gonna be like, what he spitting is real. That made them jump behind it. So it wasn't just jumping out, being signed and doing the music.
It just didn't sound good. It was real.
Yeah, that's why I say it started from 10 years old when I jumped off that porch. So while y'all riding around with them goddamn guns and y'all ain't even got no motherfucking beef, what you want to become a felon for? Right. Just because, you know what I mean? Shout out to Lil Boosie. I mean, he did a lot of the reason why a lot of them little niggas, because he always rep that keep it on you, keep it on you shit. And you know, he had the streets before he went to the joint, he had the streets going nuts. He was like the preacher.
Right.
And I used to feel like he was stealing my swag a little bit. That's my nigga. Rest in peace, Lil Bleak. Motherfucker don't know. Me, Boosie, and Bleak, we set lane at Hooters.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Right.
Kicking freestyles and shit in the parking lot. You know what I mean? I got a chance to meet Bleak, really have a real conversation, down to earth conversation with him and everything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I felt like I ain't know him like that, but I felt like he was a solid enough nigga to be able to for me to say rest in peace, Bleak. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah.
You know, shout out Boosie. He doing his shit right now.
Oh yeah.
I seen him in a motherfucking standing in the dirt, nigga. About that. I seen him standing in the basement and the house wasn't even built yet. That motherfucker. Yeah, I'm trying to get to that point though, man. I'm happy for any motherfucker that's doing good, but what I'm saying is, us as a people, we so fucked up in the head that we can't unify. And we too busy, we so trained to hate each other. Fuck that nigga, I don't know that nigga, this and that. That's what's keeping us from taking over, because we can really take the fuck over, you know what I mean?
True.
And I try to be positive. You know what I mean? I try to stay on a positive note, even though I'm a G in the street, nigga, which I'm going to be period point blank.
Right.
But that don't mean I got to be negative. I'm going to get to that.
Yeah, we're going
to
get into that. We're going to get into that a little bit. So, you know, following up that, you know, with a couple other questions, you know, like with the music, you know what I'm saying? Leading up to now, you know what I mean? You done had some bangers, you done had some hits, you know what I'm saying, out here. Of course, you know, the real Naptown, you know, that's like the one of the city's anthems out here, you know what I mean? Absolutely. And then you have the record with Crunchy Black that went crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's a record I love that record, you know.
Oh,
I mean,
damn.
You're like you know, and you got 5, 6, 7 albums, you know what I'm saying? Like,
shout out Crunchy Black, man.
All right.
People call it Crunchy Black, but it's really Crunchy.
Crunchy Black, yeah.
Black,
on the low, man, Nut did a remix to the Colts What the Hell. We played it every year for 2 years straight, every Sunday. Man, it's so dope and so lyrical with What the hell? Oh, yeah, man. One of my favorite Nut tracks as an artist. You know what I mean? I'm like, this dude just related the cult, man.
That's crazy.
Ooh, that was killer.
Hey, with that same, with that same fire.
Yeah.
You know, yeah.
So, I mean, with that, talk about some of the records, you know what I'm saying, leading up to this point, man.
Well, when I first dropped that, the Showstopper? I dropped that Showstopper, that's when I took the streets.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Jimmy Mac, shout out to Kilo G, you know what I mean, NAP, shout out to G-Stack, you know what I mean, all the brothers that hyped me up. And paved the way for me to feel like I can do this music shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And truth be told, what motherfucker, this is just because it leads back to the ignorance of black people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Even on the big industry, you got motherfuckers that can't wait for motherfuckers shine the dim down so they can be able to say, he ain't shit no more. They ain't doing that shit in rock and roll and all that shit. Why not keep a motherfucker where they need to be at, even if they ain't rapping no more?
Right,
real time.
If some shit was to happen for me, you gonna see Kilo G, G Stack, and all them niggas in my videos, even if they ain't rapping no more. I'm gonna speak on them and do all that shit. We supposed to keep them, that's what keeps the legacy going.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? But that ignorant shit is what tears the shit down. Motherfucker can't wait, oh, fuck that nigga, he ain't doing nothing no more, da, da, da. Fuck all that.
Cause
if you look at a motherfucker long enough, everybody got something you can talk about.
Come on, man. Real talk. Hey, but speaking of catching the momentum, And having it, I've also seen you pass it on. You got some young guys that, you know what I'm saying, came from under your tutelage.
They all cutting up right now.
Yeah.
If they ain't doing the music, they got a business.
Yeah.
You feel me? The Hoolums, Lil E, you know what I mean? Pootie, he cutting up right now. He got his own label, but MGG is still like a parent company, like an umbrella. It's all a branch out from MGG. Yeah. But we all bosses. We all been bosses. I always showed them that. I never tried to belittle them or make them smaller than me. You feel me? Even when they had, I could have easily, because they was my little niggas. They still my little niggas. But what I'm saying, I don't want to say was, but they my little niggas. So I was just saying in the past, you know, they was a little younger.
Right.
So I really could have had them coattailing, not saying pee on him, but I never wanted them. I wanted us to be shoulder to shoulder. When we did their parties, I ain't go pay for the party and do all that shit. I walked them in and showed them to pay for the party and be a boss and learn the shit your own motherfucking self. You know mm-hmm. what I mean?
I seen that, you know, coming from, you know, with the greatest DJs and stuff, it was different situations. We done did all kind of stuff together, but it was one particular situation. We was at Cloud Nine at the time, and it was something. It wasn't I support Lil Nut party. It was something else was going on. You was performing.
I'm gonna talk about that too.
But this one particular time, though, you know, like people was anticipating Lil Nut, and then he let these young guys get on there, and they got this song, "Let's Take a Ride." After I heard it, I was like, "Oh, I understand."
Shout out to the Hoolum. Shout out
Come
to
on,
Playboy.
Man. He, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, what are you doing, man? You know, it's you. He's like, nah, man, he ain't gonna do it. Oh, okay. You know, and then we all know what that was, and you know, it is. You know what I'm saying? Legendary. So,
talk about him at a time. See, when you doing Say For Instance, when I do shit like that for younger motherfuckers, it's supposed to keep a link going. Where they always shot you out in that manner and give you your props and keep you in them. And that's what's keeping us.
See, and that's where I was going. What's the relationship like now? You know what I'm saying? With, you know, Lil E as he moves on and doing his boss thing, and Pootie and he's doing his boss thing. And,
it's still
you know what
the
mean?
Same.
Yeah.
It's still the same. It's yeah. still our love. We were just all together yesterday.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's for sure. That's good. And that's. That's more important, like you said, in terms of building each other up. Because as they continue to do bigger things and bring more back to the table, to the family, and you continue to do bigger things and bring more back, that creates an empire. Yeah.
That's what it is. It's MGG empire.
Yeah.
You know, that's truly. That's cool, though,
yeah.
Bro.
Yeah, they
because, like, Baby, I mean, if you look at it, you know, I was watching Baby today, you know what I'm saying? And he was talking about there's not enough CEOs, you know what I'm saying?
That shit.
But not only that, I think what he was saying more of was there's not enough people that pass on the game,
right,
like you're talking about. You know what I mean? Like he was able to be able to boss up Wayne, Drake, and Nicki. You know what I'm saying? He could have kept them under him,
right,
like you said. He could have kept them not pee on it, but he could have kept them doing his bidding. But he
that's just artists.
He let them grow legs and become bosses and show them the way. You know what I'm saying? So I definitely can see how, and you know how you've done that and relate to that.
And a lot of the most I can let them spend their own money, I let them do that shit. You know what I mean? I wasn't really trapping them or nothing like that. You know what I mean? I spent bands on studios and shit like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, I put in money when need be, but you know, one motherfuckers around me never was no slouches though, cause they wasn't just getting taught on music, man. They was getting taught on all type of angles. You know what I mean?
Right.
They was straight already business. Bright. They already, you know what I mean? They already had it in them. So, you know, it just happened to fall out that way, that every motherfucker around me had a special type of glow. You know what I mean? That's why we were so strong. You know
right.
What I mean? And the way that we carried ourselves out in public, all that shit came from me. That's why I'm like the brains of the situation and all that, you know what I mean?
Right.
I've always been a big brother and an OG, letting a motherfucker know how to carry themselves. This is how you carry yourself with when you get shame.
Right.
This is how you stay humble. This is how you carry yourself when you get money. You know what I mean?
Right.
This is how you be a street nigga with class. This how you juggle all this shit and make it all work. You know what I mean?
Right.
And when we used to be out, and even the way we took pictures and did, I ain't gonna lie, you know what I mean? It's just real talk.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I see a lot of movements in Indianapolis that base their movement around how we was moving our movement. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because I know the past and the present. I know how dudes was moving before. You know, when we used to come through with the green bandanas and the brotherhood and motherfucker tell the love and see the... I seen guys and I had conversations with a lot of guys. You
right.
know what I mean?
Man, right.
I like the way y'all move. And I seen them start forming and building their shit and shout out. That's what we all, life is learning. You know what I mean?
Right.
It ain't about, I taught this nigga, nah, nah. That's what we supposed to do. That's what life is all about.
Absolutely.
Shit. You know what I mean? Yeah, I learned shit off motherfuckers.
Dummies.
Yeah, I learned shit off young motherfuckers and dope fiends, bums, crazy motherfuckers.
Knowledge is out there. You get it from everywhere.
Shit, straight up. So, that's what's up. So, moving along a little bit, you know what I mean? Let's get into now, you know, you've been moving around a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Got a couple records, you know, we definitely gonna talk about those. But I wanna talk also, you know, about what Indianapolis means when you leave outside of here. You know, now that you start moving around, and you get in different type of love from different cities, different vibes, different things of that nature. Like, talk about, you know, to the people here, you know what I mean, that are watching, talk about now your growth, you know what I'm saying, outside of Indianapolis now.
I'm blowing up just like how I blew up here when I started moving around.
Yeah.
I don't like to talk about it. I want the shit to speak for itself.
Right.
I don't like to even let motherfuckers know a lot of good shit I got going on because I've been through a lot.
Right.
And they say it's going to get real bad before it get good. And I've been in the rain.
Right.
You feel me? And it's just the sunshine's just now peeking through. This house arrest and these cases, and I went through some shit.
Yeah.
A lot of shit I can't even speak on because it's family business. You know what I mean? But what I'm saying is, I don't like to give motherfuckers, for one, I always been an element of surprise type of dude on all angles.
Right.
If I'm gonna kick your ass, I'm gonna sucker punch you. You ain't got to worry about it. You better watch him sucker punch your motherfucking ass.
Right.
You feel me? We got some problems. You ain't got to worry about me letting you know that I got a problem with you and because.
You gonna know it.
Yeah, you gonna know it when the time is right.
Right.
I ain't gonna give you a chance to brace yourself, motherfucker.
Right.
Mogul, this is a motherfucker that really done paved the way and bumped his head, and really, that's like when you got motherfuckers that's in the streets and doing all that time, like, yeah, you gotta look at it like they hung themselves on the cross for us, cause you basically look at their mistakes and don't do that shit.
Right.
So they bumped their head for you.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's the same way like I did my little niggas. I was already the shit. So if I stamp you, you the shit just that quick. You got all my fame. You know what I mean? I already bumped all my head, did all the fucked up shit for you. You don't even,
right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah, and I can already tell you, don't do that. That's just like if baby come in and call me right now and stamp me on his Instagram page. I'm famous that quick.
Right.
Because he nationwide.
Right.
Y'all told him to this nigga follow my little nigga. He the hottest motherfucker, da da da, woo woo, period, point blank.
They going.
I just did it on a more local scale, you know what I mean?
Right.
And my little niggas, they appreciate it, though.
Yeah.
They always tell me and shit like that, and that's what make me feel good as a person, feel like I done did something for motherfuckers. I love to do shit with people and shit, even though I'm a flat out G.
And you, I gotta say this too, man, because you know, not a lot of people get to come to the castle. You know what I'm saying? I've been to the castle.
Yeah.
Great dad, too, man. Talk. You know what I'm saying? Talk about that a little bit, balancing it, man.
Oh, man. Shout out to my daughter, man. Happy birthday, baby. Mariah.
Happy birthday.
Today's our birthday. You know what I mean? We already cut up this weekend. You know what I mean? Shout out to my son, Bam Bam. You know what I mean? That's my firstborn, my little sequel.
Yep.
He just like me. With his own little twist, though.
Right.
You know what I mean? And shout out Rissy, that's my daughter, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shout out my girl, you feel me?
Yeah.
I got a strong family, man. We're a power family.
That's right.
I don't know if you ever heard anybody say that. I got it in a song, that's why I went ahead and said
it. Right.
So if somebody said, motherfucker, I said
power family.
I swear. Because I seen Kevin Gates on the, Instagram talking about, don't you hate when you see another motherfucker, that's how I always feel about Boosie. Don't you hate him when you got an idea and you see another motherfucker do it first and do all that shit and you be like, damn, you should have did it first, stupid ass nigga.
Right.
And while he's saying that shit, I be feeling like that nigga got my shirt tapped or something, man. The shit he be saying in interviews and all that shit, ask any motherfucker around me. I've been saying all that shit, man.
Right.
He basically on his PTM shit. You know
right.
what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I mean.
Hold on. We're going to get into that too. So we still on the music right now. We still on the music. So check this out. Lil Nut, he got a new banger. You know what I'm saying? DJ Skrill, we're going to get that thing loaded up. You know what I'm saying? Take a break here and come back on Well Connected Wednesdays. Y'all stay tuned. Don't go nowhere. We getting into the crux right here next on Well Connected Wednesdays. Lil Nut Showstopper in the building. Nut,
my Well Connected, baby.
MGG.
Skrilla Scratch just blessed us with that Lil Nut Mega Mix right there.
For sure.
Come on, man. It's going down, man. Well Connected Wednesday. Stopbeefinradio. Viewyoulive.com. We in the building with Nut.
The Showstopper.
MGG Empire.
Dirty old golden child.
Lil Bro.
I never heard somebody with so many nicknames, man. You got a whole lot of nicknames.
Shorty Big Head. Lil Marco. Nut.
Look,
Dario Golden Chef, Mr. Hollyhead, Swamp Thing, you feel me?
Showstopper.
But every name got a reason, and you know what I mean? And, you know, I was named all them names, you feel me? A lot of people, you know, it's somebody that called me all them names.
Right, right.
No, when I call you, I said, what's up, Showstopper?
Well, people really don't know where the Nut come from. Because, you know, they call me Shorty Big Head coming up, you feel me? I had one of them neighborhoods that just name you silly names, you feel me?
Yeah.
They call me Shorty Big Head, you know what I mean? And my favorite rapper was Sebo at the time. That's who had me cutting up as a youngster. That's
Ballhead.
You playing him right now.
I do like
him. Shout out to Sebo, you feel me? That was my favorite rapper at the time, you know what I mean? Outside of Tupac, you know what I mean? But he had that song, See, Bow, the Ball, Head, Nut, you know what I mean?
He's still.
My nigga Snack, free his fat ass, you feel me? He used to call me the Big Head Nut.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? So my first started calling me that in the hood, you know what I mean? And then when I went to the joint, I went ahead and just dropped everything else and kept the Nut, you know what I mean, for the music. I was like, man, what am I gonna call myself with this rap shit?
He's like, hold on.
And it worked. Fit,
you know, it was already calling me Nut. You know what I mean?
So, go with it.
Come on, man.
And you never heard another rapper call himself that. Nobody even tried to be Big Nut, Nothing, you know what I mean? Nothing, you know what I'm saying?
You hear him now in a couple of other cities. I think it was a little nigga here trying to call himself, and I don't know what for.
Yeah.
You can use my style, but you're going to pay me a fee. Rest in peace, MC, man. My name, man.
All right. And so talk about some of the influences coming up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, who are some of the people that influenced you to do, you know, what you do, man?
Tupac, for sure. That's who made me start spitting that heartfelt shit. He one brought it to the game. That Brandon's had a baby, did something to me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I started writing like that as a kid.
Right.
You know, back then, I was touching motherfuckers. Before I got on this mic, bro, ask any motherfucker that came up with me or was locked up with me, I've been doing that shit.
Right. Knew that your music had to have substance. Songs
with hooks. I'm talking about shit that make motherfuckers recite this shit. You know what I mean? I've been touching motherfuckers with this shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Tupac, C-Bo, definitely E-40. Motherfuckers don't give E-40 his motherfucking props, but a lot of you niggas talk like E-40.
Yeah.
He the one that put that real slang into the game, the streets, music, all that shit.
That's
you know
true.
What I mean?
My cousin always said.
I remember at one time, the whole city talked like E-40 when they had it on lock, the click and all that shit.
Yeah.
Whole city talked like all that hella and all that shit, man. It was hellos and all that. All that shit come from E-40, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So E-40, when shit was thorough, you know what I mean?
Right, right. Talk about that back then, you know what I mean, when people cruise 38th and
38th Street stay fat, every parking lot fat. That's back when. Niggas was in the club, they came through in their line dances, and it wasn't even always just move out the way. Sometimes it could be, bitch, we could come through this motherfucker and move every motherfucker out the way. That's that Naptown shit. Or we finna just come through and flown our, bitch, this us. We finna let y'all know, this us. How thick we is, we all coming through fresh, you know what I mean?
Right.
And then we gonna do the same thing in the parking lot, cause motherfuckers was on that back-to-back shit.
Right.
Period, point blank. That's how them hoods were, cause back then, you know, it's different now because you wasn't great to catch different motherfuckers in different hoods and shit. Wasn't none of that shit going on unless you was kin to somebody or you was super cool with them niggas. You know what I mean?
Right.
But hood was hood. Period, point blank. You bought your shit from the hood, your own hood, all that shit. And then another thing that's so different now is that old hit shit. The music got, you know what I mean? That motherfuckers hit, taking hits and all that. Yeah, it's allowing pussy ass niggas to stick their chest out now. Because they got a couple hours. Yeah. Fuck all that. Let that fag ass nigga put in his own goddamn work. If it's that deep where he made a motherfucker mad, even that mad where he want to do something like that nigga. That's how it was back then. Right. You couldn't act tough if you wasn't tough. Your own niggas would knock your motherfucking ass up and put you back on the porch, nigga. Stay in your motherfucking lane. You know what I mean? But now it's just so fucked up. Because see, these little niggas. And shout out to all the little niggas. I ain't down them or nothing. I'm just speaking what's real. You feel me?
Yeah.
These little niggas is bringing that kid shit to the game because they ain't got no OGs. Back then, nigga, we had the triple OGs, the OGs. We had the motherfuckers under them. We had the BGs. We had the baby Gs. You know what I mean? I jumped off the porch as a baby G, but I'm acting like a motherfucker that's 40 plus because it's a chain of command.
Right.
These niggas is... these niggas is acting like these niggas, and these niggas acting like these niggas, but they all acting like the top motherfuckers.
Right.
You seen, wherever you seen one motherfucker from the hood, you seen the whole goddamn hood. You know what I mean?
Right.
And there was a chain of command, and it wasn't none of that do what you want to do shit, and you wasn't just moving in the neighborhood and saying, I'm from over here. Nah, it wasn't none of that shit, nigga. My neighborhood, you had to fight every motherfucker in that neighborhood to be able to claim that motherfucker.
Right.
Know what I mean?
You ain't gonna ride off the hood, and you ain't from the hood, you know what I'm saying?
I fought every motherfucker from my neighborhood to be from that neighborhood. And motherfuckers can vouch for that. And motherfucker had, and if you ain't fight back, you just got your ass whooped for nothing. Because we don't want you. You feel me?
I
ain't the toughest motherfucker. I ain't won every fight. If you done won every fight you got into, you ain't got enough fights, nigga. You ain't been through nothing.
Yeah.
If a motherfucker ain't never got the best of you, or you ain't ever been jumped, caught with your pants down or some shit like that, you ain't been through nothing, nigga.
Yeah.
You just somewhere safe with your people, carrying a gun for no motherfucking reason. Ain't even got no beef, wanna go make some beef. For what?
Right.
What?
And that leads into, you know, I want to get into it, you know, now the PTM, you know what I'm saying? Like, the positive thug movement, you know what I'm saying, that you've put together. And you know, you really put some great ideas in structure back into, you know, some the mentality of the youngins are trying to, you know. So I want you to talk a little bit about the PTM movement, man.
I definitely want to talk. I mean, that's one of the main reasons why I came, because people, they'll holler it, they'll come up to me and shake my hand and say it's real shit, but they still don't get it.
Right.
So I got to embed into their head. First off, I want to let them know, I want to give all the glory to the big dog, because that's where it's coming from, you feel me? I've been chosen for this. Right. You know what I mean? And that's what motherfuckers don't understand. It's deeper than rap with me. That's why I've never been worried about if I'm a blow or not. I already know what I got coming.
Right.
That's why I can kick my feet up for however long I want to and just come back in game and just shit and come through when I want to, because I understand. Motherfuckers don't understand that I've been in class this whole time. Everything I've been going through, it ain't time for me to blow yet. That's why I haven't made it yet, right. Because I'm still in class.
Right.
I'm still learning which way to lead. I'm still learning life, you know what I mean? You know what I mean?
You learn how to use your powers.
Right, and now it's
you know you got them.
And now it's to the point where I came out to Cocoon. It's going to go down. You know, mark my words, you feel me? But PTM stands for Positive Thug Mentality. It don't mean that I'm no motherfucking preacher, or don't get it confused and think it's a game and get your motherfucking ass beat the fuck up.
Hands,
thinking that I ain't no street nigga no
right.
more, I ain't no G.
Right.
Nigga, I'm more of a street nigga and more of a G just because I'm man enough to say I'm a positive nigga.
Right.
And don't get it confused. Positive thug life, that's how I'm living. That's how I'm living. I'm trying to be an example. Motherfuckers are scared to step out here. You know what I mean? But I always set trends. You know what I mean?
Right.
I feel like that's why God chose me. But it's a lot of PTM movements going on, just named different shit. And you know what I mean? So, yeah. But he gonna make it all come together.
I see the new era of Detroit.
Yeah, you know, it's different shit going on.
Yeah, like,
you know what I mean? But when you got a certain type of vision, because you in the spirit, you can see things that the average motherfucker can't see.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
But PTM basically is a street nigga that's a real street nigga, not none of that fake ass shit. A real street nigga, a certified G with a positive mentality.
Right.
A real nigga doing real shit.
Yeah, that's all it is.
Standing for something.
That's all I'm saying. This is what
with
get
some
us
principles.
This is what, yeah, really standing for something and making and see, this is what we need. I ain't saying don't be no street nigga. I ain't saying don't be no G, all that. You ain't gonna be able to stop every motherfucker from doing that. You know what I mean?
Right.
So why not just take the negativity out of it and make them do it better?
Right.
Exactly.
And that's when the motherfucker gonna take over. The street motherfucker gonna take over. Watch and see. Just gotta, this what I want the young niggas to know. Not just the young niggas, motherfuckers my age and young old motherfuckers that ain't grew up yet.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
We know
a couple of them.
And if you got something you want to tell me, I can learn from and all that shit, I'm going to listen. I ain't just trying to, you know what I mean, belittle no motherfucker none. This is some shit that needs, somebody got to step out and do something and say something. But what I'm saying is, being a thug, being a street nigga, and a positive nigga is not water and oil. The shit do mix if you really pay attention. You feel me?
Right.
Now, me busting your ass, you're going to hear me talk about busting a motherfucking ass on my music. You're going to hear me talk about doing this and doing that. But you need to understand what's really good and bad. Would you let a motherfucker run up on you and hurt you and your family?
No.
You ain't pretending to be no street nigga or none of that shit. That ain't got nothing to do with no street nigga.
Right.
If I say I'm going to kick your ass, you run up on it. Anytime you hear me talking about doing something to a motherfucker, you ain't never saying I'm starting nothing. I'm just saying on some self-defense shit.
Right.
I feel like every motherfucker should be like that. You know what I mean? That ain't got nothing to do with no street nigga or no G. You know what I mean?
Right.
And
just being a survivor.
And motherfucker need to understand, being a positive nigga, positive, good, and real is all in the same category. Negative, bad, and shiesty, all that shit is in the same category. You feel me?
Right.
So a real nigga ain't nothing but a good nigga. You know what I mean? You ain't got to be no street nigga to be no real nigga. If you a good nigga, you a real nigga.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And that's what motherfuckers need to understand. Real got his own definition. You know what I mean? If you just, being a headbuster don't make you real. They just make you a headbuster. They got his own definition. You just a fucking headbuster. I know a bunch of fake ass headbusters. coming up as a kid, I watched a cold-blooded head buster take the stand on his own motherfucking brother. You know what I mean? Right. On his nigga and all that. You know what I mean?
Not standing on nothing.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, laws tangled and screwed. God's laws and man's laws. You know what I mean?
Man.
You know what I mean?
Realest line ever, man. Positive thug motivation and movement right there. Quit construing the two.
Yeah.
That's real.
Yeah.
That's real. Because now you done messed up everything even more.
You see, they locked us up for years for selling weed, and now they got weed houses. when I went to Detroit.
Oh, my God.
Well, when you were like that dispensary, it just didn't feel right. I said, man, is this shit real? I thought I was dreaming.
Come on, man.
And it's slapping.
Slapping.
This is what I've been feeling some type of way about all these years, and now it's cool now.
In Denver, where you ain't even got to go get a car.
Listen, man, I've been there too.
Oh, man.
Looking at this, slapping. You hear me? It's a word. I couldn't help but to ask the owners, what you got to do to get one of these? Right. Hey, just real quick. I know what y'all making. I'm adding it up.
Real quick to touch on what he was saying earlier, because we smoke, you know, differently around here. Was going out to Denver worth the smoking trip?
Nah, it was the same as Cali. When I went, they smoking right in Cali. You know what I mean? But you will find motherfuckers that ain't smoking right and think they smoking right. If a motherfucker said they smoking right here, they smoking right. Oh, we just a top flight shit. We like top flight shit here.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Very
point blank.
In the Midwest.
From the drugs, from the... That's why we set that yellow. We want the strongest shit, period, point. You know what I mean? But, as far as PTM, I don't want to leave out FTR either, you know what I mean? FTR stands for free to real. And that means physically and mentally. You know what I mean? Because we got shackles on motherfuckers physically and we got shackles on motherfuckers mentally. You know what I mean? I got a lot, all the niggas I ran around with, them original M1 niggas. See, all my niggas, they either, I done seen them in the casket, I done buried them. I'm talking about motherfuckers I jumped off the porch with, ran around with, the original M1.
Right.
I done buried them. They got all day. You know what I mean? All fucking day. And they're fighting for their life, trying to get back out of here, but they got all fucking day. These are my niggas. So you don't know what I've been through, my nigga.
Right.
I got a lot of reason to figure out something and come up with some PTM shit, even though it came from the big dog too, but
right.
I got a testimony too, you know what I mean?
A lot of motivation.
Or a motherfucker like me, staying out the way. Family man, real. This is the original real nigga. It's that old motherfucker sitting in that wheelchair. He ain't probably never been in the streets. He went to work the motherfucking job, provided for his whole family. His daughters and sons are still coming. They got kids and they still coming to his house for Thanksgiving, Christmas, and now they taking care of him because he took care of all of them. That's the real nigga. Period, point blank. He's a good nigga. Right. He ain't got nothing to do with no street nigga.
Right.
You know what I mean? So street niggas need to quit trying to say these niggas that's going to college and going to work and shit ain't real niggas. You know what I mean? I know real niggas in college. I know real niggas that go to work, punch their clock, and they ain't gonna let you run up on them and play no motherfucker. They got pistol permit because they ain't get felonies like us, and they gonna pop your motherfucker.
Hey, call the police.
Take some game you want to.
They call the police, tell them come get them. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, the hardest thing in the world for some people to do is to do what they have to do. You know what I'm saying? But everybody wants to do what they want to do.
Right.
But, and that's so crazy or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So like, a mug will be like, oh man, I remember, this is real talk. I was in the service. I went to the military.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I was in the service, military, you know, all that shit. I remember before I left, a cat told me, he was like, yeah, man, that's for dudes that can't make it out on the street, you know what I'm saying? Well, you know what I'm saying? That's not true, because I done did it all, you know what I'm saying? That and then some or whatever. The hardest thing for a cat to do is to do something that somebody else tell him to do, have to do, suck it up, drive on, and keep it moving. Hey, man, I work in the daytime. Forget where I work, but I work around a lot of people that's been on their job for 20, 30 years. And I think about it, I'm like, damn, this rascal get up every day, 5:30, for the last 30 years, getting in here to get it or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Man, cats on the street, sleep. You know what I'm saying? You probably, you know, you get comfortable, you got a couple of dials or something. Man, let me tell you something. Do what you have to do so that one day you can do what you want to do. Because that quick and that easy, that right, man, that shit ain't nothing. Nothing at all. You know what I'm saying? The most you gonna do is heat yourself up and have yourself fucked up for the rest of your life. Because what you don't want is a flagpole. You know, if you ain't got one, you damn sure don't want one. You know what I'm saying? So, real talk, you know what I'm saying? You telling these cats the best thing they ever heard or whatever. Look, you're going to be who you're going to be, but be you for the right reason.
Be you, that's the main thing.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
We doing what the next motherfucker doing or what you hearing on these rap songs.
Do what's
right. Take these rap songs for what they is. A motherfucker giving you their life, what they going through. That don't mean you got to run around and try to beat them.
Yeah,
you
know come what on, I mean? Man.
It's just like watching a movie. My music is a movie of my life. I ain't telling no motherfucker to be me. I'm going to tell a motherfucker some real shit. You know what I mean? Stay the fuck out of trouble. Stay away from negativity. This is what I like to say to mathematics of life. If you pay attention to it, positive is a plus sign, addition. You know what I mean? Negative is a subtraction sign. The more negative shit you do and feed into, you subtract them away from your life. You know, whether you might not see it or not, the more positive shit you gravitate to and do, you know what I mean? You steady growing. You add into your life.
Y'all better
and you can do that as a street nigga.
What?
You can be a street nigga and do that. I'm a street nigga. You feel me? But I'm positive.
Exactly.
I get loose with you, all that. Take it how far ever it need to go, but I don't want that. And I carry myself to where I won't have to even get indulged into that. You know what I mean? You gotta cut off bad apples and dead weight. If a motherfucker ain't gonna rock if a motherfucker don't respect the way you want your life to be, how you want your shit to carry out, then you might need to cut that person off. Cause I got to go home to my kid. You ain't finna have me getting out of my motherfucking lane just cause I love you. I don't give a fuck if you my blood family. Our family ain't family. I don't fuck with all my family. You know what I mean? And some motherfuckers ain't my blood. That's my family. I don't even have friends no more. It's just all straight, flat out family. You know what I mean?
Oh, man. Life is a business. And so in the business of life, you definitely want to be doing, like my man say, that positive thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, if you in a relationship, man, try to be fair. I know it's hard for niggas to be fair. I know it is. You know what I mean?
You can do it. Definitely.
Long as you ain't got it in your head I ain't gonna never be faithful or that if a man is supposed to cheat or something like that, then you on the right track, man. I ain't gonna judge you or judge no motherfucker for no shit like that, because we all human. The flesh is weak, you feel me?
Well, it do.
But I just know once a motherfucker get in the spirit, because I pray a lot. I pray all day. I'm the reason why my kids, the first thing they do when they slide up out their bed is get on their knees and pray. They pray over every meal, all of that, my whole family. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I pray a lot. And what makes my prayer so strong is that my faith is strong, and faith is believing. If you believe in God, then that means that you got good faith. I ain't talking about just, I'm talking about really believing where you can be at the bottom of the barrel, feel like, nigga, you finna, I'm talking about finna.
Been there.
Yeah. And still not be worried.
Straight up.
No. You know what I mean? And then he show you every time where he just take you up out of that.
Bro.
And this is my testimony that makes me carry myself and be the way that I am. That's why I praise God so much. Hey. As a street nigga. You see, shout out Kevin Gates. You see him do the same thing. Because I know it's a lot of dudes following up behind Kevin Gates. If I see another motherfucker stand like Kevin Gates with their hands crossed, I'll just fuck him. But shout out Kevin Gates. He's doing this thing, man. When I first started getting into him, Lil E turned me on to him before he was even big. But while Lil E was locked up, going through what he was going through, I started digging into him before he was even big. You know what I mean? I said, man, he's gonna make some noise.
Yeah, he got it for real time. So let me get your opinion while we're talking some music real quick. Let me get your opinion on the music scene at home. You know what I'm saying? What do you see, you know, here? What's the, you know, what are your...
A whole lot of talent with no unity and no motherfuckers and people not playing their position, man. The DJs got to step up. You know what I mean? The fucking DJs got to step up and really break motherfuckers instead of just putting them out there a little bit. Break that shit.
Yeah. And you done had that problem.
And the clubs, the fucking club owners get your motherfucking draws out your ass. And niggas that have made a name for themselves, treat them like stars. How fucking big do they got to get? They got to get all the way on BET for you to VIP them? God damn. Well, I mean, this is the shit that's going to make them. That's why I don't have. If a motherfucker going to make me stand in line, I don't go to the club. My name big enough where you can let me in this motherfucker, man.
Right.
You feel me? VIP me, slap a band on me, ask me how many with me. I ain't going to bring 50 motherfuckers. You feel me? You book me for a motherfucking show, don't walk Yo Gotti. Shout out Yo Gotti. Don't walk Yo Gotti through the back and have me coming through the line with tickets in my motherfucking hand. I ain't going for it. Walk me through the door he at, I'm parking where he at, and set me in the room where he at, nigga. Or fuck it.
Right.
You got to stand for something. But see, motherfuckers ain't playing that with positions. But just think of what that'll do. If I got an artist from here, you know what I mean, and I'm a club owner and I bring Yo Gotti. And Yo Gotti look. And he come through the door and he got his people that he look like, man, who the fuck is this nigga? You know what I mean? I come through the door, mom's brother, and then, you know, all motherfuckers like, oh yeah, this nut. You know what I mean? Introducing this arm motherfucking nigga here. He didn't want to talk shit for us. Let motherfucker know about this Snapchat shit, you know what I mean? Woo-woo, he solid nigga, you know what I mean? Yeah. Woo-woo, this is the shit that gon'. But if a motherfucker ain't never doing that, that's gonna lead Yo Gotti to feel like he run this motherfucker every time he here.
Mm.
You feel me?
Mm.
That's what that, but so the club owners, the motherfucking concert promoters, they motherfuckers got to step up and play their motherfucking position, and they need more unity. Without unity, it ain't going to be nothing but motherfuckers going to each other's necks. Motherfucker don't want to, my buddies don't want to bump nobody else because they my buddies. You know what I mean? If the motherfucker got good music, play the motherfucking good music.
But I think you also, know what I mean? But do you think also that sometimes the street element of what goes on, you know what I'm saying? Because everybody's in the, everybody's in the streets. You know what I'm saying? And things go on and happen. Like, does that affect the unity and things, going on in the music? You know what I mean?
Yeah, it does affect it. That's why it goes back to when I was telling motherfuckers, cut this dead weight and bad apples off. Be a stand up on your shit. Quit whining about it. You want to do it, but you ain't doing it. So, if a motherfucker ain't with you because you stood up on what you need to stand on and they cut out, then you did yourself a favor. They wasn't ever really with you any motherfucking way.
Right.
They gonna file in suit if they with you. Mm-hmm. You feel me? If motherfuckers start, this is what I mean by motherfuckers playing their positions. Artists gotta put their foot down and do all that shit. You know what I mean? Also, artists, if you wanna be a motherfucking musician, then you need to live like a musician. You need to be living in studios and interviews and doing shit like that. And saying, bro, network, quit trying to mix. And I understand why motherfuckers be in the streets. And you know, I understand all of that.
Right.
But it ain't what you do, is how you do it. You know what I mean?
Right.
It ain't what you do, is how you do it. You feel
That's
me?
Real.
But, yeah, motherfuckers got to play the positions, from the DJs to the club owners to the concert promoters. You know what I mean? I ain't going to say no names. But I had a motherfucker booked. My motherfucker had booked my motherfucking artist for a show, you know what I mean, one of these clubs, and then I called him like, shit, I need about 5 passes, you know what I mean, because it's going to be me, my girl, her motherfucking buddy, she don't want to be just with hard legs,
right.
You know what I mean, my little brother, you know my right hand going to be with me,
right.
Shit, my mama's son, right. You feel me,
absolutely.
You know, I need about 5 passes, that ain't asking for a lot. Motherfucker, you gonna let Young Thug in this motherfucker with 90 motherfuckers.
Yeah.
And he ain't gonna give you a dollar.
Right.
At least you can keep the network strong with me where we can grow together. You feel me?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But what I'm saying is, you know, basically a motherfucker didn't fall in suit. I ain't wanna fuck up this shit, so I basically, he told me that, why hollered at your artist? Have you talked to your artist? No, what's up? Oh, I told him that he can get 4 tickets, but 2 of them had to be for you. What kind of shit is that?
Yeah.
What the fuck do we even need tickets for, my nigga?
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
You done got your motherfucking drawers in your ass because you got this room with this motherfucking bar in it? Right. Any motherfucking hustle up and get a club, you feel me? Or go get an investor like most of these niggas is doing and spend somebody else's money on this shit. Let's be real, what I mean?
And I can also attest to that, though, because I was at a concert at Verizon, Clips. whatever, you know what I'm saying? And it was I was with Jawan Johnson, George Hill, and Eric Gordon, all together. And they were walking back to the green room, and the security guard was like, "Where are your bands?" Motherfucker's like, "Motherfucker, we don't need no bands in this motherfucker." Like, yeah. "You want bands? Here's bands." Like, you know what I mean? Now he's talking about a green band, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, "Do you got your credentials?" And like, I just imagine myself being in LA and Kobe going to a concert, going back to the green room, and they being like, "Well, Kobe, where's your wristband?"
Yeah, it's bullshit.
Like, that's the mentality, you know what I'm saying, here.
Just
you know
like how motherfucker like, told me, like, you know about the little chicks, is what I told you that, so, this okay, I'm being a player. I ain't really tripping, the shit don't make or break me, you feel me? Okay, come to the motherfucker. I still feel like I'm y'all waiting too long to get to this motherfucking door, on this side door. Slide me in this motherfucker. I got my bitch with me, my girl with me. I'm sorry, baby.
Don't make me look bad, pimp.
I'm sorry,
you know she watching.
Yeah. I got my girl with me, you feel me? My woman, and we trying to get in here. I'm nut. I'm the showstopper. Yeah. You feel me? I done made a name for myself. What's the whole point of me making a name for myself? You feel me? Yeah. Okay. By the time we get in, I'm still trying to be a player. We don't get no courtesy bottle, no nothing. We the reason why it's more people in here that would have been in here, my nigga. That's why the fuck you called us.
Right.
To add to this motherfucking show. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Right.
We really paying for our motherfucking self, dude.
Right.
Add it up. Ain't no concerts going for no less than $20 a ticket. Right. You know what I mean?
Right.
Even if I get an extra 100 motherfuckers in here. You gave me $1,000 for the show and the bottle. Where the fuck did you lose?
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But motherfucker too busy trying to be big guy, little you, all that old bullshit. We all gonna shine, my nigga. It's shit that you can be able to do, I can't do. It's shit that I can be able to do that you can't do.
Yeah.
We all gonna shine. You feel me?
Yeah.
But we get in there, I'm like, man, look, let me get about, I think it was my girl's birthday or something. I'm like, man, let me get about 3 or 4 bottles. Cause I got an entourage, let me get about 3-4 bottles, just let me get a hookup. Now me on the bottle, man, you got to holler the bartender, man, I already did enough, man, I could have broke that nigga face, and you know who the fuck you are, but I ain't gonna put your motherfucking name out here, I could have broke your shit. You know what I mean, you done did enough, what the fuck did you do for me? Let me in this room with this bar? Ain't nobody room with a bar, nigga, and some speakers?
Right.
You feel me? I done did enough, like give me 2 tickets? But you got my artist on this motherfucking stage. That shit ain't 100, man. I just had to put that out there, though.
Already?
Yeah.
Already?
Real talk.
Well, let's keep on moving with it. You got Nathaniel Red on?
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Nate Red. You feel me? I'm an ambassador for Nate Red.
Okay.
You know what I mean? For one, I've been knowing Nate since I was young. He been bossing up.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And when I had first got out the joint, free my nigga Mob G and Cheesy, you know what I mean? I think he was married to their auntie or something like that, you know what I mean? And back then he was riding Lexus, being all that, you know what I mean? So I kind of looked up to him as far as in a shine manner back then, you know what I mean? So I already know what he about, you know, he a stand-up guy, about his business,
right? You
know what I mean? And as I see how he carry himself, I just like the way he critique his shit and all that, and I like the way he reached out to me, you know what I mean? To where I'm like, this is what we supposed to do.
Right.
I use my hypeness to hype your shit up more too. And you, along with your page, you got me on your shit hyping me up. This is the unity that's gonna make this shit roll over, you feel me?
Right.
So, you know, and plus he should be looking like real clothes.
Yeah. You know, man, it's nice, man. I like the jacket, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Shout out, you know what I mean, Nate Red.
Yeah,
He's been through here.
Yeah, I got some more shit though. Yeah, you know what I mean? But yeah, I'm ambassador for Nate Red Clothing, and I do have some stuff dropping. My PTM line, it ain't really a line. It's just going to be a lot of positive slogans that's going to make a lot of sense.
Oh, that'll be dope. You know what I mean?
For the women and the dudes.
Gotta drop the drop, nigga.
And I'm going to take the game from him when it's time to do my Omar Kabu clothing line. You know what I mean? I'm going to take the game from him, but I'm going to rock with him until he you know what I mean, we're gonna muscle him up and shit, but I'm also learning to get the game, and I'm ready to branch off and do my own Markaboo. But I want my shit to look quality like his, though. Shout out Nate Red.
Shout out Nate Red, man. That's what's up, man. We're in the city, you know what I'm saying? That's, like you said, we all shine, man. So, Treez, I'm sorry. You had something?
Spend locally, think globally.
Yeah. So, moving, you know, we gonna get to the end of this thing. I know you gotta get back, you know what I mean? Get out of here, and you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's been a pleasure, though. I mean, if y'all, to tell y'all the truth, bro, this is like, I ain't no big-headed nigga, you know what I mean? Yeah. This is like a pleasure to me. There's a lot of motherfuckers that'll never get to sit down in a chair and motherfuckers want to interview them in front of their mic. That's big to me. Even though we ain't at the Breakfast Club or nothing, this is the City Breakfast Club.
Right. I appreciate that. Y'all heard it. Nut, man. Stamp, man. The way y'all
spoke about me when I came in this motherfucker, all this shit, this is shit that's going to keep get us rolling. Them is props.
Yeah.
Know what I mean?
But you earned them, though, bro. Right. They just made no shit up, though.
Right. You already know.
Yeah, it wasn't scripted. You know what I'm saying? I said on your mixtape, when you a real nigga and you standing for something, people going to stand behind you. You know what I'm saying? Sure. You know, real. People rally to some bullshit sometimes, but they're not going to continue to rally to no bullshit, bro. Right. You know what I'm saying? Real talk. Mud's been rocking with you, man, for, you know, some years, you know,
heavy.
Some calendars, you know what I'm saying, real talk. Yeah. Hey, you one of them cats or whatever that I would be pressed to hear somebody say something bad about you and somebody not say, what you say?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Real talk, bro. You know what I'm saying? Just because. I wanted to mention this earlier.
Ain't nobody got no reason to say nothing bad about you.
No.
Man. If they do, it's a motive.
Hey, bro, listen, to listen real to talk.
Shit. Some type of
if you ain't no haters, you ain't popping. But real talk though, my man was locked up, and they had the free little nut, you know, party or whatever. We had just did, it was Plies. I don't know, somebody just right before we did the music, you know, DJ all that, the promotions, and everything. The little nut party was twice as fat as what they had cracking. Real talk. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It was
that's
a cloud
nine.
You
I
know
appreciate
what
everybody that came out for the free little nut party, man. I love y'all.
Hey, amen.
Real.
Super stupid, bro.
And it
helped the brother.
Yeah, it put some help me put on that lawyer.
Come on, man.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was my little brother them. They all put that together. They helped me down.
That's real,
well,
man.
Kept
that's
my
what
books
I
fat. I 50 balls every week. Right. Sometimes I put 50 on somebody else's books and order 100.
Right.
Straight up.
It was good to see, though, man, like, the impact that this brother, you know, has had, you know what I'm saying, not only on the music, you know, scene, but on the community as a whole, you know what I'm saying, because, oh, they showed up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They showed up and they showed out, you know what I'm saying, in a positive way. You know what I'm saying? I just say that if you able to touch people like that, you know what I'm saying, from where you was, you know, with the movement and everything, the sky's the limit, brother. You know
let me show them, also, let me show them these cups, man.
Shout out to all the people that sent me fan mail.
Come on, man.
With them letters and stuff, too.
You got the cups, man. MGG Empire. I noticed you had to switch up to Empire, you know what I mean? Everybody was calling it, you know what I mean?
The entertainment.
Yeah. You know what I mean? The entertainment, you was calling it something else. You was like, man, let me switch it up to Empire.
The mob.
Yeah, the mob.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I ain't gonna lie. You know, we came through, you know, we come through, we mob when we do what we do, you feel me?
Yeah.
But
show up, show out.
You know, I go through it. My people don't know I go through a lot of shit with the law, too.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers that don't even know me, they pull people over in my neighborhood, what you know about nut, what you know, and I'm actually living a positive life. You know what I mean?
Right.
They don't know me personally. They trying to paint this picture and do all that. So that mob word was
building a connotation.
Yeah, like some Rico Act type shit. You know what I mean? So,
move away from that.
Hell yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, I got to goddamn it be here for my kids, my family, and all that. You know what I mean? I did this to let people know that MGG is a business. He ain't just in Indianapolis. You know what I mean?
You go Detroit, you already know.
Atlanta, Texas, yeah. Mississippi, yeah. Memphis, Ohio. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Moving, man.
But it is, man.
Well connected, man. Stop Beefing Radio, ViewYouLive.com.
103.7 The Beat. This has been an exclusive live, man, with Lil Nut, man. So look, man, who you want to shout out, man, before we take him out, man?
Man, I hope I don't miss nobody and shit. But I want to shout out first the whole city. I love all y'all, east, west, north, and south. The street niggas, the motherfuckers that go to work, the school, the kids, the elders. You know what I mean? Us as real niggas, we gotta hold up these elders and these kids. That's what it's all about. Holding them down. You feel me? We need to take it back to back when your mama made you go in the next room and she rolled up a joint and shit. Quit doing all this shit in front of their eyes. Give them a chance for their own legacy.
That's so
shit.
Real, man.
You know what I mean? We gotta take it back to that down to earth solid shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just that positive shit. It ain't gonna make you less of a street nigga, but it's gonna make you more of a man than a real nigga. You
gotta have structure.
Once you gravitate towards that positive shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Period, point blank. And I want to shout out the whole Midwest. I've been repping that Midwest heavy in my soul. Because I've been throwing that M and that W up. And like when I'm out of town, I'll say, where you from? I'm like, I'm from the Midwest. You know what I mean? Indianapolis, Indiana, Naptown. I say it exactly like it.
Yeah.
Because I want to put that Midwest in their face.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I want to let them know Indianapolis, Indiana, and the nickname for that motherfucker. And it make me feel good when I go places and be like, I'm from Naptown. I like to see if they already know what it is. I'm off of like, what is it? Like, in the Naps. Oh, okay. And then next time I come new and motherfucker know what it is. Oh, this my nigga. He from Naptown.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He from Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got real niggas. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm folk, what you heard is pussy niggas everywhere. It's fake niggas everywhere. And everywhere the pussy niggas and the fake niggas got the real niggas outnumbered because shit didn't change.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's real niggas in Indianapolis. I can vouch for a whole bunch of them. You know what I mean? Real tough. I want to shout out to the whole world. You know what I mean? All praise is due to the big dog. You know what I mean?
Yes,
he want us to have love for everybody. So I'm willing to love everybody unless they fuck that up. That don't mean I trust you or none of this shit.
Right.
But it's straight positive with me. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Period, point blank. You know what I mean? And shout out to my whole label, my board of directors. You know what I mean? My artists, you know what I mean? Shout out to my family, you know what I mean? My old lady, my kids, Bam Bam, Mariah, Marissa. Happy birthday to Ra-Ra, Mariah, my oldest daughter, my little personal nurse.
Right.
She already cooking full-fledged meals and everything. She just turned 10 today. She cooking the whole house breakfast and everything. Foot rub, back rub, I love it. My little daughter, she holds me down too. She's growing. She's going to be doing it too, you know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah, but she only 7 right now. So.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I want to shout out 25-8 Music Group. That's my DJ, DJ Rally.
Yeah.
We say 25-8 because 24-7 ain't enough.
You
know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And DJ Rally finna cut up. You know, he's a capper too, so he connected him in college.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But tell he's a smart dude. I learned a lot from Rally on a smart end.
Right.
He teach me all them big ass words and shit. He be talking to me, I be like, hold up, man. He made me pull the dictionary and shit. What this shit mean? Ah, man, you know what that mean, man. That's what it
means.
You know what I mean? Shout out DJ Rally. That's my dog. We done got real close, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shout out to DJ DJ and all the greatest DJs, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
That's my DJ too. I carry him as my DJ. Shout out to the 625 Music Group and Ready Rock. People don't know Ready Rock did a lot for me. Ready Rock will wake himself up out of his sleep to come somewhere and correct some shit for me.
Right.
Or come in the middle of the night if he know I'm in foul trouble with some timing on some shit or something like that.
Right.
He held me down on a lot of shit. You know
that's
what I mean?
Real,
showed
man.
Me a lot of shit. I got a lot of love for Ready Rock, you know what I mean?
That's what's up.
I want to shout out to Trap Stars. These are other DJs that's behind me. I carry as my DJs. See, this is where the Young Thug song come from. This is where the Cap One song come from. And a lot of people don't know. I just did a song with BWA King. Y'all about to hear that in a minute. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But see, this is more like some DJ Khaled type shit. Like DJ Khaled saying, you put your verse on this, putting that type of shit
right,
together.
Right, right, right.
mixtapes, live mixtapes, that type of shit. That's yeah. where them songs coming out. I never met Young Thug, shout out Young Thug. I never met Cap One, you know what I mean? Shout out Cap One. I met BWA Kane, solid nigga in my eyes, you know yeah. what I mean? We really kicked it down in Atlanta, you know what I mean? Shout out BWA Kane, you know what I mean? He was real down to earth, went on no Hollywood ass shit, you know what I mean? And he already knew who I was, really. Once I, he didn't know me by my face, but he knew me by my name.
Right.
I think he got some people up this way or something.
Yeah.
Ohio and Indianapolis, he got some people and shit.
Yeah, he moved around a little bit up his way.
Yeah, so shout out to the Trap Stars, DJ P Exclusive, he's in Canada. DJ B-Lo, he's in Jamaica, you know what I mean? Rally just became an official Trap Star DJ too, but he got his own shit too. He's hood rich, you know what I mean? Shout out Rally, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shout out to Atlanta, Georgia, man, they've been embracing me real heavy. I fuck with Playboy and went up to Mojo Studio. He embraced. He a real nigga, street nigga. You know what I mean? He run a lot of shit down there. Shout out Mojo. Mojo, sign yourself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's for people who don't know, that's Gucci right here, man. You know what I mean? I fucked with Alley Boy in there. Lynn Tate.
Lynn Tate.
Yeah, we kicked it real heavy in there. You know what I mean? Alley Boy, real street nigga. Fuck all the shit that's on the internet. Shout out Alley Boy. He was clutching the whole time in the booth. Kept that phony on him. And you can tell he gon', you feel me?
Right.
Real talk. I know street niggas when I see them, bro.
Yeah.
You take one and know one. Right. You know what I mean? Yeah. Anybody, what real gangster you know don't get a couple bumps and bruises upside this shit sometimes.
Yeah.
He caught with his pants down. So I don't look at him no different, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shout out Alley Boy, you know what I mean? My little nigga that's coming up, Eastside the G, he from the Eastside Zone 6. I've been fucking with him real heavy. He a young nigga, you know what I mean? I think Eastside the G about 2021.
Yeah.
He had a Juicy J bumping his shit, all that shit, you know what I mean? He be having me on all his mixtapes and shit like that, you know what I mean? But he doing this thing, young nigga from Zone 6, you know what I mean? Shout out Eastside the G.
Yeah.
I want to shout out Endless, Endless Entertainment. That's Moneybag Yo now. That's, Zach Randolph.
Yeah.
Shout out Roger, you know what I mean? Roger real nigga, you know what I mean? That's Zach Randolph's little brother. He running the music end of that shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They behind Moneybag Yo. Moneybag Yo about to cut up.
Oh, he about to cut up. He was just with my people. Shout out Big Rankin, you know what I'm saying? My big bro, they just did the listening session with him down in Miami this past weekend, man. You know what I'm saying? They've been, you know, so they've been rocking. You know, I always tell people, like, I've been watching now for almost about 6 or 7 years, you know what I'm saying? I've been watching artist after artist after artist come through this system and this network and this pipeline, you know what I'm saying? And being connected to it is a blessing, you know what I'm saying? And I'm always trying to get people to just, you know, I think, and Baby said this too, he was like, they don't spend the money, you know what I'm saying? Now, there's also value in relationships, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, at the end of the day too, you know, it's gonna take that investment in yourself with those relationships and in the right timing, you know what I'm saying? A lot of the times, but.
You wanna invest in yourself? Why I'm investing in you?
Yeah, I mean.
I've never been afraid to invest in myself.
Yeah.
I put it all on the line, you know what I mean? Yeah.
She bounced up. She cold with it. She hit the club and it's Murder One, that first degree.